Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Italy, a country located in South Central Europe, occupying a peninsula that juts out into the Mediterranean Sea. This country is known for being the homeland of very popular foods, pasta and pizza. Well, an Italian dog breed is gaining immense popularity here in the United States as well, the Cane Corso. Hey guys, what's going on? This is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV. If you would, please subscribe to the channel. If you can, if you want to support even more so, hit the join button and become a channel member. All right guys, let's jump into this video. The Cane Corso is a large, muscular, mastiff-type dog that has been around Italy for hundreds of years. Having descended from the Roman war dogs, the Cane Corso worked as a farmhand, flock guardian, property guardian, family guardian, and hunting dog, particularly hunting big and dangerous game like wild boar. This dog has a very large head and heavy body. While his build is strong, he has an elegant appearance with long and powerful muscles. The muzzle of the Cane Corso is very deep and broad, and his neck is muscular and slightly arched. The Cane Corso is a balanced dog, large bone, rectangular in proportion. The length of the dog measured from the point of the shoulder to the point of the buttocks is approximately 10% greater than the height of the dog measured from the highest point of the shoulder to the ground. So the breed height for males is roughly 25 to 27 and a half inches, females 23 and a half to 26 inches. Weight should be proportioned to the height of the dog. As a breed, the Cane Corso is intelligent, assertive, and confident. Very loyal with an even, stable temperament, dogs of this breed are easy to train, and it is recommended that training and socialization occur from the very beginning. The natural tendency for this breed is to take charge, so the owner must establish that he or she is a pack leader and take control at a very early age. Boundaries must be set with confidence, as the dog most likely will test them. The Cane Corso is good with children and can do well with other dogs when supervised. Plenty of activity is important for the breed to keep them physically and mentally healthy. The Cane Corso will enjoy jogging with his owner or taking long hikes. The breed is a great protector, and while generally calm and friendly with their owners, often acts suspiciously and aggressively towards strangers. As a protector of his property and of his family, the Cane Corso is unequaled. Because the breed is a very intelligent and willful dog, obedience training can't start too soon. The first thing that you'll want to teach your puppy is a recall. That is, coming to you when you call them, as well as a sit and stay, stop and leave it, all of which are potentially life-saving commands. Although smart, Corsos aren't exactly known for being eager to please, and they get bored quickly. So keep the training sessions short, exciting and fun, reinforcing obedience and desired behaviors with high-value treats and lots of praise. In general, puppies can start puppy socialization classes as early as the age of 7 to 8 weeks. Puppies should receive a minimum of one set of vaccines at least 7 days prior to their first class. Now, these puppies will grow to be very large and powerful dogs. So even though we can't start classes until 7 to 8 weeks, it is very important that we start socialization from the day that the puppy is born. This means introducing your puppy to the sights, the sounds, and any strange things in the world that he will encounter. This will make for a more stable and confident dog as it ages. The Cane Corso needs a fair amount of daily exercise and mental stimulation. After all, they are a working dog and need to be kept occupied and have a job to do. They require at least 45 minutes to 1 hour of exercise each day, but they will never say no to more opportunities to work. Without the opportunity to release all that pent-up energy and to challenge their minds, they can develop behavior problems. This can include barking, digging, destructive behavior, and escaping to explore the world on their own. In some cases, this frustration can lead to aggressive behavior. There are three main types of exercise and activity that you must provide your Cane Corso every day. One is a daily walk. Two, purposeful activity, including building muscles. And third, mental stimulation. Considered to be a light shedding breed, the Cane Corso requires minimum grooming. His short hair can be brushed regularly with a soft bristle brush to remove dead hair, and his nails should be trimmed as necessary with a nail clipper or grinder to avoid them overgrowing and cracking. The ears of the Cane Corso should be checked regularly to be sure that wax buildup and debris won't be there to lead to an ear infection. Regular teeth brushing is important as well. Maintaining your dog's dental health is very important. The Cane Corso has some health conditions that can be of concern, especially if you aren't cautious about where you get your dog from. They include hip dysplasia, eye problems such as entropion or ectropion, demodectic mange, and a tendency toward gastric torsion, that is also known as bloat. The Cane Corso is an amazing breed, and if you're lucky enough to bring one of these dogs into your home, you should do your best to care for this animal properly. That means regular vet visits, feeding it the appropriate amounts of food, high quality food at that, and be sure that you do all you can do to keep your dog healthy and happy. If you are interested in bringing this dog breed into your home, I highly recommend that you check out the Cane Corso Club of America.